Hi friends, as you know that I am Dr. Jetling Ellosa and I am running a YouTube channel called Law Speeches, in which I am posting the matters pertaining to the different subjects of law and also topical issues of the world. And today we discuss the burning topic the world is facing, the COVID crisis. For that we need proper medicine, drugs, therapeutics and equipment to combat it. But we have regime called intellectual property regime. The patent rights are there. The drug industry is one of the biggest industry in the world, where it is dominating by the third in the developed countries companies, and one or two developing country companies also having some sort of sway over it. So today we discuss all those aspects. And before going into details of it, I would like to request you to subscribe to my channel, press the subscription button and also the bell button for notifications. If you feel that my lectures are informative and knowledgeable, spread among your communities for the purpose of transforming the knowledge. So just now I stated that we are facing the COVID crisis, and many developing countries, they have unable to cope up with this crisis in medical manner, including India, which is considered as one of the biggest and dominant drug manufacturing country in the world. It is facing a lot of problems, where in currently the essential drugs which are essential for the life saving, like the remdesivir and some other drugs, they are not available in the market, and the black marketers or hoarders are selling it in exorbitant prices. Even the conditions are such a pathetic that the equipments which are required, like oxygen cylinders, oxygen equipments, so all those are heavy demands in our country. Why all these things happening? Because you know, we have intellectual property regime is there. So intellectual properties are the properties which have been created by our intellect, our mind. So the person, they put their minds and brains and they get some sort of a new innovations. So intellectual properties are those properties which include the patents, trademarks, copyrights, know-how, designs. So all those are be considered as the intellectual property rights, because they emanate from the brain, from the mind. And the maker, the inventor of such property has the right to claim those. If the inventor is given the benefit, then only the scientifically it can be lead to more research and development and innovation of the new products, new processes. So the royalty should be claimed and should be given to the innovators. So with that view, we have the intellectual property regime is created. The one of the main purpose of intellectual property regime to expound the scientific temper and knowledge in the world. So, but on face of intellectual property rights, when certain emergencies have come out, like the present scenario, then how to combat? For that also, the different countries have made different kind of regimes in domestic jurisdictions are concerned. In our India, we have the Patent Act is there of 1970, and with regard to trademarks, with the Trademarks Act, with regard to copyrights, we have the Copyright Act of 1957, with regard to designs, we have the Designs Act of 2000. So different intellectual property enactments are enacted by the Parliament from time to time. So here today, we're discussing the one important aspect of the patent rights, that is the compulsory licensing. And under what circumstances the compulsory license is given. So you know, a patent is granted to a patentee for his efforts for innovating a new and useful and non-obvious thing. So as per the World Intellectual Property Organization, the patent is defined in these words. So it runs, and I quote here, a patent is an exclusive right granted for an invention which is product or a process, in general a new way of doing something, or offers a new technical solution to a problem. So while intellectual property organization, which monitors the intellectual property rights around the world, which is one of the body of the agency of the United Nations organization, which defined in simplistic words that a patent is nothing but it is a exclusive right. So it is a special right and is given to granted to a invention, and the invention may be a product invention or a process invention. You know, in the patent regime is concerned, we have two kinds of things are there. One is a product patent, other is a process patent. So here, the patent can be granted in product way or in process way is called as a patent. And that product or patent is granted for a new innovation. So such a thing is not there before to it. Now it has been innovated. Then, like a new drug, a new medicine is innovated, then the inventor has a right over that innovation. A new equipment is innovated, that also comes under the patent regime. So, the person who invented a patent is called a patentee in the legal term is concerned. And you know, in India we have the Indian Patent Act is there, 1970 Act, though basically the act is enacted basing upon the Nehruvian model. So Nehru had a intention of socialism in his mind. Basing upon it, this act is enacted. For that we have Ras Mannar Committee was constituted, and Bakshi committee was constituted basing upon the recommendations of these two committees, the Indian Patent Act was enacted in 1970. It is very, very a comprehensive act, provides everything in it. So every, what is an invention is there, the definition is provided, and what are the rights of the inventor, the patentee, what are the rights or duties of the patentee, and when it will be open to the public domain, and when it may be considered as to be given as a compulsory license, or all those aspects have been well mentioned in this Patent Act. So the act is made for the purpose of public welfare and public interest in connoisseurs with the develop the temperament, scientific temperament and scientific interest over the sciences. And as per the international conventions, because the General Agreement on Trade and Tariff was started in 1948, and later in the last round, seventh round, that is be called as a Uruguay rounds, where the trade related aspects of the intellectual property rights, in short form the TRIPS, has been added. There the TRIPS patents also became a part of the TRIPS regime under the World Trade Organization. So now as per that, we have process patent is there, we have the product patent is there. When the India was made act in 1970, we only had the process patent and we don't have the product patent regime. But we have signed it, the WTO document. In 2000, we made amendment to the Indian Patent Act, and also in 2005 also we incorporated the product patent regime into the Indian Patent Act. So things are like that. So patent, as I told you, improves or encourages the scientific invention, but it also creates a kind of monopolistic right in the patent holder. So in balancing these two, the Indian Patent Act is enacted. Now we have seen the shortage or dearth of drugs, medicines, therapeutics and equipment to combat the COVID-19 situation. In India, we have only two vaccines are available. One is a domestic vaccine, that is the Covaxin, developed by the Bharat Biotech. The other one is a Covishield, which is developed by the British AstraZeneca company, and which is indigenously made by Serum Institute of Pune. Though they have making the lot of production, but the government plans to vaccinate the citizens is not up to mark. The shortages we have seeing, we are getting news. In developed countries, the situation is quite different. In America, the 60% of population has been vaccinated. In England, 60% of population is vaccinated. And Europe also, in Italy, France, Germany, which are developed countries, there much of the population is vaccinated. But in our country, only the 17 crore of population is vaccinated by one dose or the second dose. Only 3 crores of people have been vaccinated with two doses. It shows that there is a scarcity of vaccines to combat the COVID-19 pandemic. So, how to cope off? One side we have the Indian Patent Act, very strong regime. The other side, the public interest is involved. So with that view, in international level also the same thing. In Africa, if you go to Africa, as on today only 1.3% of African population in 54 countries have been vaccinated. It shows sorry state of affairs, because in Africa they don't have any pharmaceutical industries. Whatever be there that may come from the Europe or bulk from the India. So, though India is a giant in the pharmacy sector, but when there is a situation is in demand, we are unable to do. So that is the reason. Because of the vagaries in Africa, the government of India had dispatched 6 crores of vaccines to the foreign countries, mainly to the Africa and South America, ignoring the national demands. So, to cope up all this, not only national level, in international level also, we have certain legal regime is there. So that legal regime is, because a patent holder is given a patent, and when demand is there, public interest is involved, then how to cope out that such a situation. So with that view, first I will discuss the international level. For that we have way back the Paris Convention of the Protection of the Industrial Property of 1883, where in which there is an article 5 clause number 2 is provided, which provided the compulsory licenses. If it can be issued by the respective state parties within 4 years of applying of the patent or 3 years from the date of granting of the patent. So that provision is there. Why? Because compulsory license. Because compulsory license is required to face the emergency situations. If not, we are unable to face such situations. And that is way back in 1883 of the Paris Industrial Property Convention. If you go to the North American Free Trade Agreement of 1994, under the Article 1704, also provides this kind of compulsory licenses to the other companies to manufacture under the title of Anti-Competitive Acts, so Antitrust Acts, because as I told you, the patent rights or intellectual property rights lead to some extent the monopoly of the aspects, because the person who have been invented has the right to marketize, exploit the such things. So under the antitrust enactments there in North America, in USA and Canada, these the compulsory licenses can be given. Even after the World Trade Organization came into force from the 1st of January of 1995, there we have, I told you, the TRIPS trade related aspects of intellectual property rights under Article 31, which provides that basing upon the individual interest of the nations, the public interest exemptions can be given to the patent monopolistic rights, and the compulsory license can be granted to the other companies. Because when there was an outbreak of AIDS, HIV in Africa in 90s, Africa countries have faced a lot of problems to cope up with the issues. There was a dearth of drugs, non-availability of drugs. Availability is there, that drugs are very, very costly, unaffordable. Rates were fixed. So, in Doha round, which has happened to the TRIPS in 2000, it was accepted that public health, and the paragraph 4 is added, where if the public health is required, is a paramount, then the compulsory licenses can be given to medicine and medicinal products. Then the compulsory licenses also been there in China, People's Republic of China, under Article 48, Clause number 1 of the Chinese patent law, which provides that if the grave danger is there, a public interest is warranted, then a patent holder right can be kept abeyance and a compulsory license can be granted by the government. For that, only ground was available is that the patent should be in existence for 3 years, or the patent application is made 4 years earlier itself. So only these two is there. Basing upon it, a compulsory license can be granted. Then, now we will discuss the Indian scenario and with regard to compulsory licenses. So as I told you that Indian Patent Act is a balancing act which provides protection to the patent holders, their rights, and also gives prescribes certain duties to the patent holders or patentees. The social duties have been castigated upon the patent holder as well upon the state also. For that we have to see the Section 84 to Section 92. These are the sections which deals with the matters pertaining to the compulsory licenses. So under what circumstances the compulsory license can be granted? For that we have to see that number one is reasonable requirement of the public with respect to the patented invention have not been satisfied. So public, the patent which has been granted is not satisfied the reasonable requirement of the public, then a compulsory license can be invoked under the law. The second ground is the patented invention is not available to the public at reasonable and affordable prices. A patent which is granted should be afforded to the public at reasonable prices. If it is not, then in such scenario, a compulsory license can be granted, basing upon the reasonable, affordable prices. The patent can be, the compulsory license can be granted for other companies to manufacture the products. Number third is, the patented invention is not valid in the territory of India. Suppose a company gets a patent, but it is not working, not simply they take the patent and keeping quiet, keeping mum. In such scenario, because demand is there in our country to regard to that product or that process, then under compulsory license process procedure prescribed under the these sections of 84 to 92, the patent, the compulsory license can be granted to the other companies by the controller of the patents. In addition to that, the section 92A provides that the government feels a patent right can be kept aside in the interest of the public. So public interest is there, then the patent right can be kept aside. So that is the another aspect which we have to take into consideration. So I just told you that now many political parties in India have demanding that the local made vaccine for COVID-19 should be given to the other companies, like the only Bharat Biotech is producing the vaccine, but some political parties and some companies also making the application that they should be given the that is kind of licensing. Because when the Bharat Biotech, though it has a partnering with the government of India, when the demand is there, when it is unable to cope up with the demand in production, then these should be given to the other company. The government of India is saying that it is not possible because other companies, they don't have that capability to produce the vaccine for the COVID-19. Maybe that sounds good. Even the same thing was stated by the government of India before the Apex Court, the Supreme Court. But some companies are coming out. And you know, we have in international level, the South Africa and India jointly submitted an application to the Council of the World Trade Organization for exemption of the patent and intellectual property rights regime to this COVID-19 drugs, pharmaceuticals, therapeutics and equipments. For that, the President of USA, Joe Biden, also supporting for exemption, one-time exemption. That process is going on. But here, in India also, we have to adopt the same process. Because when a single company is unable to produce, then it can be given to other companies for the production. So under the compulsory license, you know, as per Indian Patent Act is concerned, even a compulsory license is invoked, the patent holder should be given of his royalty. He should not be denied of the royalty. He can entitle for the royalty as per the act. So that should be thinked of. And in addition to that, if you see the case laws which have happened in India with regard to the compulsory licenses, basically only few case laws are there that we will discuss now. The first case law is NATCO versus Bayer versus NATCO case, which is reported in India. So where the first time compulsory license is invoked. Your Narco company, a pharma company based at Hyderabad, they applied for the drug which is manufactured by the Bayer company. The Bayer company is holding the patent rights. The drug is called Nexavar, which is a drug is used for the treating the liver and the kidney cancer. And the Bayer company, because of the holding the patent, they selling the 1 month course drug in the market for 2.8 lakhs rupees. And that is very, very exorbitant way they have charging from the patients. So Narco company came out similar sort of the drug for the only for 9,000 per month. So which is very affordable to the common man. But Narco, the Bayer company had stated before the control of the patents that the Narco company cannot make a drug because they are holding the patent rights. But the control of the patents, relying upon the public interest, affordability of the price to the common man, rejected the argument of the Bayer company and granted the permission to the Narco company, Narco Pharma, to produce the Nexavar drug. In one more case, that is the BDR pharmaceutical company versus BMS company, where so BMS company, they invented a drug for cancer that is called as the Sprycel, S-P-R-Y-C-E-L, Sprycel. And the BDR company filed an application before the controller stating that they should be given the license to make the drug, because the BDR company, BMS company, is not coming for negotiations. They are ready to pay the royalties, are they ready to pay the all these things to the company, but they're not coming forward. And so credible, they made a credible efforts. In spite of that, the license is not granted to them and it should be granted to the company. But the controller of patents rejected the grounds that the BDR company not properly negotiated with the BMS company, so the compulsory license cannot be granted to BDR company with regard to drug which is holding by the BMS company. And recently one more case, that is a case of Lee Pharma case, where which is also a Hyderabad based company, pharmaceutical company. They filed an application on the 29th June 2015 before the controller of the patents, stating that they should be given permission to make a drug called Saxagliptin, which is invented by the AstraZeneca, which cures the diabetes. And they Lee Pharma also argued that they made a negotiations with the AstraZeneca company to giving up the permission to manufacture, but they have not coming with their proposal. And they are delaying the giving of the permission. So unreasonable time they have taken. So it should not be there. That is the contention of the Lee Pharma company. But the controller has stated that they also not, the Lee Pharma company has not made proper negotiations with the AstraZeneca company. So which does not comes under the compulsory license to be granted for this product held by the AstraZeneca. So the application of the Lee Pharma company were rejected. So these are the three important decisions. And as you know, the COVID-19 crisis, the many companies are coming and filing the applications before the controller with regard to the manufacture of the Covaxin. So it should be transfer of the technology from the Bharat Biotech to them, because the Bharat Biotech is not in position to product the needs, so under the compulsory licensing. So maybe that within short time we can see that, like the companies, those include Insight Holdings Corporation, maybe it within short time the controller of the patents of India may give the grant the compulsory, invoke the compulsory license under section 92A of the Indian Patent Act, because when they are not in a position to meet the public demand, because vaccination is only option available to us to face this pandemic, combat this pandemic. So in shortly they will take, the controller of patents will take a final decision. Maybe the legalism is very clear, because whatever legal regimes are there around the world, including India, which considers that public interest is paramount to that of the patent rights, intellectual property rights. No, those are to be respected, no doubt about it. When we respect those rights, then only there may be scientific innovations may be possible, because the companies have been dumping lot of billions of rupees upon research and development. They should be extracted of their money. Without that, no companies won't come forward. In India, we have, though lot of population, 136 crores of population is there, it is a pity to note that only in a year 15,000 patents have been granted. But you go to Taiwan, very small, tiny country, and some European countries, tiny countries, per year they're getting 1 lakh or more than patents. So that shows that we should give lot of respect, lot of encouragement to the scientific temper, because the COVID, maybe now we have the COVID-19 crisis. In future, you can get some new sort of diseases, new sort of illnesses, yeah, new sort of things may come. To face all those aspects, we need drugs, medicines, and technologies to face. That is possible by only we encourage the intellectual property regime. Otherwise, there may not get any solution. So with this, I'm concluding my lecture. Thank you for patiently hearing me. Once again, I request all of you, if you feel that my lecture is informative and knowledgeable, please share among your communities. Thank you, one and all.